Like 2 weeks in February. All right, we got a 5-year supply of luxury homes nationwide. The high-end housing market has yet to see signs of life. Many, though, now are turning to high-end auctions run by concierge auctions to narrow their search. Most recently, the company sold Cher's Hawaii home for more than $8 million. George Graham is CEO of Concierge Auctions. He joins me now on the set. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Is it true that the luxury end, luxury part of the market is not doing nearly as well or not recovering to the same degree that we're seeing maybe in the middle part of the market?
No, it's not. And that's partly, Michelle, because it's really a post-Lehman phenomena. And really, it's only in the last 6 months that owners of these homes have realized that that world post-Lehman is going to be very different than the pre-Lehman world.
So when you say post-Lehman, in other words, when we talk about the lower end of the market, that stuff started to just crumble and actually caused the Lehman's. The high-end market came later? That's the idea?
It's exactly right. The high-end market really is a function of the repricing of the market. There's less financing available. You know, pre-Lehman, super jumbo financing, anybody could get it. You look at the bankruptcy of Thornburg Mortgage, they're not around anymore. Mm-hmm. People that are actually buying homes today are real buyers. That's really what's changed. Pre-Lehman, these buyers were looking to make a speculation. Now people want to own these homes to live in them.
All right, so you just sold Cher's house for $8 million. Is that because she couldn't sell it normally? Or why would anybody turn to an auction instead?
Good question. But no, Cher actually had not even listed the house and looked at the market that she's in Hawaii and Kona and saw that there was the supply that you're referring to. And she decided that she would rather sell it today and realize the real market value than have it on the market for the next 2 to 3 years and have to carry the house.
Have people walking through, looking at her shoes, looking at all the clothing, right? I mean, just get it over with?
Well, fortunately, it's a house that she built as an investment, and she didn't live there.
Oh, she didn't live there. Okay, how many people, when you say more and more people are turning towards auctions, give me some context. 5 years ago, you did how many, and now you're doing how many?
Well, actually, 5 years ago, there wouldn't have been as many because the industry is relatively new. Today, we're doing multiple auctions every month. Our next auction coming up is going to be in Dana Point, California. We're selling a house steps from the Pacific Ocean. It's going to be selling for $6.9 million or a little bit above that, and we're really excited about
it. How does it work? People have to show up. They hold up a paddle. They do it over the phone. They can call in. They can write in a bid. This is the place, I assume, that we're looking at here.
Yep. Yes, that mm-hmm. is the home, actually.
Yep.
Well, actually, you have to be pre-qualified. You have to register a bid. This isn't an event. This is a real auction because our platform is really the only luxury auction platform out there that's the equivalent of the Sotheby's platform for selling art and antiques.
Got it. Even though they have started to get into homes, are they going to give you some competition?
Well, no, we have a 10-year agreement with Sotheby's International Realty, and we're the preferred provider of auctions for that platform.
Got it. Mr. Graham, thank you for coming in.
Thank you, Michelle.
Cher's house. I would like to have seen that. All right, now we have brand new comments from Treasury Secretary.